Ever wondered about how the residency match works? Whether you're a pre-med student figuring out which medical schools to apply to, or a soon-to-be MD or DO graduate waiting for match day, knowing the statistics about match rates could be helpful. What factors influence match rates? How to choose your residency to secure a match? How important is your medical school for residency matching? These are some of the questions we'll answer in this video. Plus, we will reveal which medical schools in Canada and the US have the best match rates. Hi, my name is Chris, and I am an admissions associate here at BeMo. Before we get started, be sure to subscribe on whatever social media channel you're watching this from now, so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos. If you would like us to help you matching with your top residency, click on the link either above or below this video to schedule a free initial consultation. As a quick tip, check out the timestamps in the description of this video to navigate to specific sections of the video that you're interested in. Here's what we plan to cover today. Factors that influence match rates. How important is your school for residency matching? Which schools have the best match rates in the US? And top 15 schools with the best match rates in Canada. By the way, we're giving away $50 Amazon gift cards every week to the best comments and questions, so comment below for your chance to win. There's this one thing that will dramatically increase your chances of being accepted into your top choice residency, and I'll explain at the end of the video, so make sure you watch the entire video to find the answer. Now let's get started. There are some other crucial factors that could impact how students are matched to a residency. Specialty choice, competitive specialty, preferences. An important factor to consider in residency matching is how the match rates of different specialties influence the overall match rates for a medical school. Applicants from elite medical schools are more likely to apply for the most competitive residencies, such as surgery, dermatology, and so on. These residencies generally have the fewest spots and high admission standards. Statistically speaking, this means students applying only to competitive residencies are least likely to get their first choice residency match and may sometimes not get a match at all simply due to their choice of residencies. Some medical students are focused on these competitive residencies and do not want to compromise with any safe options, which could lead them to not get any matches even if they have excellent US MLE scores and belong to top-ranked medical schools. This could also work in reverse. Applicants opting for least competitive residencies like family medicine and internal medicine are more likely to get matched, and hence schools could have excellent match rates due to their students largely applying only to these safe residency choices. This also explains why some DO schools have better match rates than allopathic schools. The osteopathic medical curriculum is focused on primary care specialties like internal and family medicine, and primary care residency programs, especially those with a pre-existing osteopathic affiliation, could give their students preference. The flip side of this consideration is that many of the most competitive specialties give preference to students from high-ranking medical schools. This could be due to several other reasons other than the perceived prestige of the school. For instance, most of the top medical schools have excellent research facilities and often have the resources and connections to help their students gain early, significant experience in a specific specialty. They may have a wider list of affiliate hospitals for students to complete their rotations in, and they may offer specialized medical training in the highly competitive specialties. Due to a combination of these factors, applicants from these schools may have a more impressive resume for competitive residencies. Residency-specific placements. Every medical school has a different focus and setup when it comes to the medical training they offer. Though the basic medical school curriculum is the same, some programs may offer more training opportunities in a specific specialty in the form of additional elective courses, a more focused curriculum, clinical rotation options, research exposure, hospital affiliations, and so on. As a result, some medical schools have a reputation for training students in a specific specialty. Students from such schools are more likely to choose and get matched to the same type of specialties, and this influences the residency match rates for those programs. This could be simply because those schools attract students interested in that specific specialty, and those students seek out residency spots in the same specialty. And residency directors are more likely to accept students with extensive previous experience in that field and with a perceived commitment to their specialty. For instance, students who graduate from the best medical schools for surgery, such as Johns Hopkins or Harvard University, have a higher chance of getting into competitive surgery residencies. Moreover, many medical schools affiliate with hospitals belonging to a specific specialty, and students, while completing their rotations in those institutions, use the chance to form useful connections and gain meaningful experience that gives them an edge when they apply later for a residency position in the same program. Both perceived commitment to specialty and audition elective slash rotation within department are key factors for residency directors determining who to accept. That is why, for example, certain primary care-oriented medical schools like New York Medical College, Howard University College of Medicine, and the top osteopathic schools have a great residency match rate equal to the elite medical schools. It's important to remember that overall and school-specific match data changes from year to year. While we can discuss overall trends and probabilities, it's hard to predict exact numbers because there are a number of factors that could change the results. Every batch of medical students has a different composition, and every med student has a different priority. And these intangible changes add up to cause minor fluctuations in match rates. Demographic influence, location. Location is a key concern when it comes to residency matching. Residency is a long-term commitment to a specific hospital and location, and applicants may prioritize applying to residency programs only in specific locations, especially if they have family commitments. On the other hand, some residency programs may prioritize applicants from local medical schools as part of their official policy, or simply because these students are more likely to have completed rotations in their department. Therefore, medical schools in that region will naturally show higher match rates. Language. Some residency programs have a strong preference for applicants who meet specific language requirements. For instance, residency programs based out of Quebec service mostly French-speaking communities and hence prefer applicants who are fluent in French and have received their medical training in French. This gives applicants from French language medical schools an edge, and their residency match rates could be boosted as a result. Recent NRMP data shows that in the US, the overall match rate is 78.5% for all applicants, including international medical graduates. This means that quite a few applicants don't get a residency match at all. This is simply because the residency matching process in the US is very competitive, and there simply aren't enough residency positions to match the number of applicants. Nevertheless, it's a scary prospect for any medical student to not get a residency match after all the time, money, and hard work invested in medical school. So, what does influence residency matching? How do residency directors make their decisions? A recent NRMP report explored the key factors that programs consider when matching residents and how important each factor is. According to this report, graduate of highly regarded medical school was a selection factor for 46% of programs, and the median importance they gave this factor was 3.6 out of 5. But it was only 25th on the list, which means 24 other factors are, on average, considered more important than this one. Traditionally, your experiences, scores, and other application components have a much higher influence on your match chances than the reputation of your school. Ultimately, belonging to a medical school with an excellent match rate is not a guarantee you'll be matched to the residency program of your choice. your USMLE scores, resume, letters of recommendation, interview, etc., will be the final determinant of your success. Success and excellence are not a direct result of which school you go to, but of your own effort and skills. In the US, applicants use the ERAS portal to apply for residency positions, and the National Resident Matching Program, the NRMP, matches applicants to medical schools across the US. NRMP does not release information about residency match rates based on medical schools, but there are some specific trends in matching that are interesting to note. Generally speaking, elite schools, such as Ivy League medical schools and UC schools, have the best match rates. These are the match rates of some of the top medical schools in the US. Harvard Medical School. As per data released from the Harvard Medical School Office of Student Affairs, Harvard has a match rate of 95%, with 46% matched to Harvard-affiliated programs. Of the unmatched students, two graduates pursued oral and maxillofacial surgery, and the remaining pursued non-clinical positions. Will Cornell Medical College. As per data released by the school, 99% of Cornell applicants matched to a residency, and 91% of these matched to a residency position in the top 50 institutions. Yale School of Medicine. As per the Yale School of Medicine Office of Student Affairs, most of Yale's medical graduates matched to a residency program. 94% matched to one of their top five choices, and 91% matched to one of their top three choices. Stanford Medicine. A few years ago, Stanford Medicine boasted a complete 100% match rate for all 85 of their medical graduates. Stanford has not released their latest specific residency match rates, but they continue to have excellent overall match rates, and their graduates get into the most competitive residencies. University of Pennsylvania, Perelman School of Medicine. According to the latest data released by the school, they have an overall residency match rate of 98%. It's not just top-ranking medical schools that boast excellent match rates. Some smaller universities that focus on less competitive residencies like primary care also have excellent match rates. Creighton University School of Medicine. According to the latest data released by this school, 100% of their graduating class matched to a residency, with 91% getting their first choice residency. 53% of their students matched to the primary care residency positions. University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill School of Medicine. Their latest data confirms that 96% of their graduating class matched to a residency. Kansas City University College of Medicine. Their latest residency match data shows that 99% of graduating students matched to a residency. Howard University College of Medicine. According to their latest reports, they have a residency match rate of 89%. There are also some interesting match statistics to consider when it comes to DO versus MD matching rates. According to the latest NRMP data, the overall residency match rate is 92.8% for US MD seniors and 89.1% for US DO seniors. Overall, allopathic medical graduates have a slight advantage over their osteopathic peers when it comes to residency matching. However, the best osteopathic medical schools could have higher match rates when compared to some lower-ranked or even top-ranked allopathic schools. For example, University of North Texas Health Science Center, College of Osteopathic Medicine. According to the data released on the official website, in the last few years, 99% to 100% of their graduating DO students have found residency placements. Lake Erie College of Osteopathic Medicine. Their latest data reveals that 99.1% of their graduating class found a placement in a graduate medical program. Lincoln Memorial University College of Osteopathic Medicine. Their latest data shows that 94.1% of their graduating class was matched to a residency. In Canada, medical school seniors and graduates use the Canadian Resident Matching Service, or CARMS, to apply for residency positions. According to the latest CARMS data, the overall match rate of a Canadian medical graduate to residency spots in Canada was 96.6%, with 81.7% of these applicants getting matched to their first choice residency. The match rate for international medical graduates was 29.1%, and for U.S. medical graduates was 59.5%. As per CARM's data, these are the medical schools in Canada with the highest residency match rates for Canadian medical graduates. Number one school, Northern Ontario School of Medicine. Number of students entering match, 59. Match rate, 100%. Number two school, University of Ottawa Faculty of Medicine. Number of students entering match, 161. Match rate, 99.7%. Number three school, Memorial University of Newfoundland Faculty of Medicine. Number of students entering match, 81. Match rate, over 95%. Number four school, University of Toronto Faculty of Medicine. Number of students entering match, 263. Match rate, over 95%. Number five school, University of British Columbia Faculty of Medicine. Number of students entering match, 293. Match rate, over 95%. Number six school, Queen's University School of Medicine. Number of students entering match, 100. Match rate, over 95%. Number seven school, Université Laval Faculty of Medicine. Number of students entering match, 235. Match rate, over 95%. Number eight school, Schulich School of Medicine at Western University. Number of students entering match, 172. Match rate, over 95%. Number nine school, University of Alberta Faculty of Medicine and Dentistry. Number of students entering match, 168. Match rate, 90 to 95%. Number 10 school, Michael G. DeGroote School of Medicine at McMaster University. Number of students entering match, 203. Match rate, 90 to 95%. Number 11 school, Université de Sherbrooke Medical School. Number of students entering match, 197. Match rate, 90 to 95%. Number 12 school, Université de Montréal Faculty of Medicine. Number of students entering match, 326. Match rate, 90 to 95%. Number 13 school, Dalhousie University Faculty of Medicine. Number of students entering match, 114. Match rate, 90 to 95%. Number 14 school, McGill University Medical School. Number of students entering match, 193. Match rate, 90 to 95%. Number 15 school, Cummings School of Medicine at University of Calgary. Number of students entering match, 165. Match rate, 90 to 95%. As can be seen from the list above, Canadian medical schools have excellent match rates for Canadian medical students. The main reason for this is that Canadian residency programs generally prefer placing Canadian medical graduates, i.e. applicants from Canadian medical schools. It's much more difficult for US and international applicants to get a placement via CARMS. Check out our blog to learn more about the residency match and how it works. I've included a link in the description of this video so you can find the blog easily. If you would like us to help you match for residency, click on the link either above or below this video to schedule your free initial consultation. Hopefully you enjoyed this video and received the answers you were looking for. Please subscribe, like, and leave a comment, especially if you would like a chance to win our $50 Amazon gift card. If you have any further questions that were not covered in this video, let me know in the comment section and I will get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you next time.